Good day, everybody. Welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week, we're going to create a reflection in the cityscape that we have here on the screen. We're going to create two different looks. We're going to do our colored look here with some water movement in our reflection and also our black and white conversion as well. So this is the photo that we're going to use this week. It is from Unsplash. That, as usual, will be linked below. Let's start off by creating a copy of our picture here with our command J, and I'm going to make this a little bit smaller with my command minus. Come over here to my crop tool to start off with, and just up here on the toolbar you'll see this little button called straighten, and I'm going to click on straighten. It'll give us this little spirit level, and I'm going to position it right along the top of the water here, and I'm just going to click once and drag that right underneath the boat there, and that will give me a straight line to work with. While I'm on the crop tool, I'm going to just crop out this transparent bits on the background here by moving these points up and in and clicking on apply up here. And the next tool we're going to use is the rectangular marquee tool here. And I'm going to drag out a square with my rectangular marquee tool all the way down to the water's edge. I don't want any of the water. I am going to zoom in with my command plus, and holding my shift key, just drag up and just make sure that those lines are right underneath the water's edge. When you see all these filled in black arrows here, it means you can move that selection up or down. So I'm just going to move it right underneath that walkway and not get any of the water. Command 0 to make it a little bit smaller. And I'm going to copy that selection twice with a command J, 1 and 2. And now we can hit command D or escape to get rid of those marching ants. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is make this a little bit smaller again and just move it up a little bit. Coming back to my crop tool, I'm going to increase my canvas size. I'm just going to come down here to this point here, going to increase my canvas size to about 2600 on the rulers over here and hit apply. And that'll give me some blank space down here or a transparent space down here. So with this top layer highlighted here, I'm going to come over to my move tool and I'm going to come over to arrange and flip vertically. So it'll flip this top one upside down. I'm going to drag it down, make this a bit smaller, command minus again, just drag that down, snap it into place, but let's zoom right in, and you can see we've got two sort of walkways or those little bushes along the walkway or whatever it is. There's two of them at the moment. Let's just use our arrow key to arrow up just so we've just got the one there and we've got our nice reflection. And we need to come over with our side arrow key a bit more here, and that looks pretty good. So let's make that a little bit smaller with our command minus. And let's move this background layer now. Let's move this underneath this layer here. Let's call this layer Cityscape. Call this layer the Reflection. And on this Reflection layer, let's make another copy of that with our command J. And on this first Reflection layer, first thing we're going to do is make that a little bit smaller so we can see it. Going to come up to filters, blurs, and motion blur. We want our motion blur to be set to 90% at about 35. Down here, we'll take it to 35. Looking pretty good, and hit apply. Going to make that a bit bigger with my command 0. Okay, next thing we want to do on this reflection layer is come up again to filters. Let's go to distort and ripple, and let's make that a value of 4 and apply that. And you can see it's given us a slight ripple to those buildings. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is come over here to our toolbar and look for our smudge brush tool here. Click on our smudge brush tool. We want our flow at 25 and our strength at 10. Fairly big brush. Let's just brush over the bottom part of that picture just to give it a little bit more of that ripply reflection in the water, and that looks pretty good. Okay, these two reflection layers now, I'm going to highlight both of those reflection layers. Come over here to my move tool, make sure we're on layer, and go merge selected. Let's add a new pixel layer down here on our new pixel layer. And this layer we're going to fill with white. So let's come over here to our fill tool. Make sure we're on white. Click on the bottom here. Just fill this bottom area with white. This bottom area again on this white layer. We're coming back to filters. We're going to go to noise and add noise. We want it all the way up. We want 100%. We can't go higher than that. So we want 100%. And apply. I'm going to copy this noise layer with a command J to make it a little bit stronger. Highlight both of them. Make sure I'm on my move tool, layer, and merge selected again. Okay, that's just to make that noise a little bit stronger. On our noise layer here, we'll come up to filters, come up to blur, and again, motion blur. This time we'll set our rotation to 0. And bring it up to about 50 and hit apply. And that stretches that motion blur out, sort of stretches it like along in lines instead of up and down. So we've got it going along this way. On our noise layer, we're going to come down here to our adjustments. We're going to add a levels adjustment. This levels adjustment, we're going just to clip it to this white pixel layer here. On our black level, we're turning it all the way up to about 90. So 90 looks pretty good. So let's click on this layer here now. We'll make it a little bit smaller with our command minus and just using our spacebar, move it up a little bit. Come over here to our perspective tool. And on these little squares here, we're going to drag that out and down, drag that out and down. And we're going to bring these ones in a little bit. Make sure clip to the top and bring that one in a bit. What we're trying to do here is make these lines look a little bit longer and these lines look a little bit shorter, a little bit of water perspective. So it looks like the water further away is the lines are a little bit smaller and closer to us, the lines are a little bit bigger. So let's hit apply on that. Command 0 to get it back to normal. This layer here, we're going to come up to our blend modes here. We're going to change the blend mode to soft light. And we're going to change our opacity down to 25%. You can bring that down a little bit more if you think those water ripples and the water lines are a little bit strong. You could bring it down a little bit further. I'm going to leave mine at 25% for now. And there we go. We've got that nice reflection. We've got some of those water ripples as well in the reflection. The next thing I'm going to do is right on top here, I'm going to add a brightness and contrast layer. And on the brightness layer, I'm going to bring the brightness all the way up to about 80. And I'm going to bring the contrast down to about 40. On this brightness and contrast layer, I'm going to invert it with a command I. I'm going to grab my paintbrush. Make sure we're on a nice soft brush. You want the color to be white. I want my flow to be 10%. The opacity can stay at 100 with a fairly big brush, not too big. Just on here with a white brush, I'm just going to start painting, clicking and dragging up all the way along the picture here to get a little bit more brightness there. And I'm going to do the same going back on the city. I'm just clicking and dragging down with my mouse. One more little thing just on this reflection layer here, the bottom reflection layer, we might just grab our blur tool and just with our flow down to about 40, 39, 40, just on the bottom here, I might just blur that a little bit more. Okay, the next thing we can do is grab all these layers on the top layer, hold our shift key down all the way down to our bottom layer here. Make sure we're on our move tool again. Layers, and this time merge visible, which will give us one copy of our picture with all of our adjustments in it. Come over here to adjustments, and I'll click on my actual black and white preset. And I created this preset by watching the Affinity Revolution tutorial on black and white. So that's the actual black and white settings. If you wanted to copy them down and make your own preset, that's our black and white copy. Let's turn that off for a second. If you have the Nike or Nik plugins, you can do one of my favorite looks, which is filters up here, plugins, night collection, Silver FX Pro, and you can do one of my favorite looks with this, which is the silhouette look down here. But I would bring down the contrast a little bit and bring down the brightness a little bit, and also bring up the structure a little bit to make my favorite look for this picture, and hit OK. So there we go, everybody. We've got our Nike plug-in silhouette look. We've got our black and white look and our colored look for our reflection. Started off just with the picture of the city, and we've created three different looks. So I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.